Hi everyone, welcome back. Do you want to customize the view drop-down list component? Then you must watch this video to learn how easily you can customize the drop-down list component using built-in templates option in the view drop-down list of Synfusion. The drop-down list supports several options to customize each list item's group title, header, and footer elements. Look at this online example. You can see the drop-down list pop-up showing the web platform names and images. Here, each list item is split into two columns to display web platform name and image. Also, you can see the drop-down list pop-up shows customized header and footer. Okay, now I will proceed to show you the code snippet to achieve this customization using my existing Getting Started application. Let me open my existing Getting Started application where I have added the view drop-down list with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple view drop-down list, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this existing Getting Started example from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Here, to have better clarity, I am replacing the remote data with JSON data collection, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely name and ID. Also, I have mapped the name field to text property and ID field to value property. I have assigned web platform names to data source. So, let me change the placeholder property value as select a platform. Also, ensure whether this data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the drop-down list. So here, you can see the drop-down list showing web platform names. Now, I will show you how to add images for drop-down list items. To customize drop-down list items, within the data function, first, I need to define a variable drop-down item template. Now, I will start to define the template. Here, I have planned to display web platform names and images in drop-down list items. So, let me define div and span elements. To add web platform image, I need to modify the existing data source by adding one more field image with appropriate values. Then, I will assign this newly defined data source field image to class attribute, as I'm going to use background image attribute to add image to span element. To add web platform name in drop-down list item, I need to assign this name field to another span element. Now, let me assign this variable drop-down item template to item template property of drop-down list component. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this item template. So here, you can see the drop-down list component showing web platform names and images. Now, I will show you how to add header for the drop-down list pop-up. To add header for drop-down list pop-up, first, I need to define a variable drop-down header template inside the data function. Here, I am planning to display the text photo and platform as header in drop-down list pop-up. So, let me define span elements with the text photo and platform. Okay, now I need to assign this variable drop-down header template to header template property of drop-down list component. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this header template. And now, you can see the drop-down list pop-up displays the text, photo and platform as header. In case, if you would like to show the total list items count at the bottom of the pop-up, then you can make use of footer template property. To set footer for drop-down list pop-up, within the data function, let me define a variable drop-down footer template first. Then, to display total list items count in the drop-down list pop-up, I need to define span element with the text total list items 5. Now, I will assign this variable dropdown footer template to footer template property of dropdown list component. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for this footer template. Now, when you look at the dropdown list component, where the pop-up is displayed with the text total list items 5 at the bottom of the pop-up. Next, I will show you how to customize the dropdown list selected value. Here, to have better clarity and focus on value template, I'm going to remove the code snippet of the properties item template, header template, and footer template. Then, I have planned to display employee name with designation while selecting the value. For that, first I need to replace the existing data source with employee JSON data source, which contains an array of objects with three fields, namely name, ID, and designation. Also, ensure whether these name and ID fields are assigned to text and value properties respectively. Now, I will start to define the template. So, within the data function, let me define a variable dropdown value template. Then, I need to define span element and access the data source fields name and designation to add employee name and designation in dropdown list selected value. Okay, let me assign this variable dropdown value template to value template property of the dropdown list component. So here, you can see the dropdown list. When I select the item, it shows employee name with designation. Finally, let me show you the steps to group these data items using group template property. To group the data items, first, I need to define one more field country with appropriate values on each object of the existing data source. Then, I will map this newly defined data source field country to the group by option within the fields property of the dropdown list component. Here, I have planned to display country names in bold and italic font. So, let me define a variable dropdown group template and add HTML elements bold and italic to it. To access the country name, let me assign the data source field country inside the HTML elements. And now, I need to assign this variable dropdown group template to group template property of the dropdown list component. Look at the dropdown list now. The data items are grouped under the category USA and England with bold and italic font. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to customize the view dropdown list items as well as selected value. Also, we have seen how to add header and footer for the dropdown list pop-up and how to customize the dropdown list group title. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. If you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching this video.